Hey everyone, Bry here from AVEVA, along with our exciting new partnership, Databricks, and our good buddy here, Shiv.
Awesome, good to be here, Bry. Thanks for having us at the Paris conference.
Awesome, well thanks for coming and supporting it. This is obviously an exciting time for me and you. We started on this journey, I don't know, 6-8 months ago maybe?
Yeah.
Announced it 6 months ago. Seems like we've known each other a little longer than that. But super excited about our relationship, our partnership of bringing together industrial, you know, specificity with the broad capabilities that Databricks brings to market. Can you maybe give a little point of view on what Databricks thinks about this partnership and why you're so excited?
Yeah, first of all, I remember very clearly 6 months ago when we first met, it was like an idea on the back of the napkin on how we can make industrial data the first party citizen in enterprise AI. And I think it's very exciting today, you know, this week, with Matei and Casper announcing it in the way that they did. And I think it's a huge step forward for the industry. At Databricks, we've been instrumental at delivering AI at scale for the better part of the decade. And we've been very, very successful in knocking down silos in almost every industry in the world. And this is why the partnership with AVEVA is so exciting, is because we saw the opportunity to truly activate industrial AI, which is so badly needed for virtually every company in this industry, to remain relevant, to remain competitive, and build the businesses of the future that are highly efficient and very sustainable.
Yeah, I think, you know, we've been, obviously, AI in particular has been something that when it first came to market, industry's always been excited about it, particularly with the opportunities for, you know, process efficiency, sustainability, all types of reasons. The challenge has always been, you know, they can do a single project, maybe a POC, but doing that at scale has always been difficult. And one of the big reasons that it's been so difficult has to do with the quality and the consistency of the data. And I know this is something that's actually really near and dear to Databricks' heart, because that's also, I think, something that you guys also strongly believe that is really the foundation for any AI.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, there are two worlds that the most platforms were operating in, the data world and the AI world, and they were kind of running in parallel universes, and that's true as much for industrial organizations as it is for other industries and other companies in those industries. I think what we've done very, very well is bridge the gap between industrial data or any type of data with the AI development process in a way that you can track it back, and having high quality data is absolutely critical, because without that, you cannot have good AI systems. You cannot have reliable AI systems that business users can trust and can make decisions off of. And I think it's a game-changing approach, right? By having the domain expertise of AVEVA, the unique nuances of industrial data, you guys take out a lot of the noise from the very high-value signals. And that, in turn, allows for faster value realization on the AI side. You know, we can sit here and do science projects all day, but at the end of the day, if nobody's making better decisions, then all of data and AI strategy has failed. So I think this is an opportunity to really take the guesswork out of industrial AI and really deliver to the market a reliable foundation to go enable the next set of industrial AI outcomes.
Yeah. 100% agree. I think the other challenge for organizations is not just getting the data into the AI platform, but how do you take the insights, the forecasts, the innovations, and bring those back into the systems that the operations teams are used to using? And I think that's really where this thing really comes to life. It's not just about being able to bring some of the data sets, clean it, make sure that it's industrial grade, mm-hmm. make that available natively inside the Databricks platform, but also allow for those data scientists, those developers, to be able to take those insights and push those predictions back down into the industrial systems that, quite frankly, AVEVA delivers for them.
Yeah, and you know, exactly right. And I think what was really cool about this conference is we actually put this stuff in the hands of our customers, right? And Agnico Eagle Mines, you know, we showcased what was possible with AVEVA Connect and Databricks coming together. So think about all their industrial sites, their process data from their mining operations is completely being matched with their logistics operations, their haul trucks, and being able to make sure that you have the right utilization of the trucks, the operator safety is taken into account in terms of what are the rates at which these trucks are arriving, what rates at which they're being loaded, and that is immense value in terms of not just lowering costs, but making them much more efficient from a fuel utilization standpoint, and that is a direct line impact to sustainability. So I think we're going to see way more outcomes like that, as we bring this technology and make it real for our customers. And I know both of our organizations are are really excited. I can speak from my own vantage point that, you know, we see tremendous response from the customers at this conference and excitement. And I think there's the best is yet to come, and we want to drive this with speed and clarity.
Yeah, I definitely feel like there was a buzz. There was a buzz at the conference in general. I think people are obviously recognize the challenge ahead with regards to some of the sustainability challenge that we have. Obviously, every day on the news we get, you know, another climate challenge. I was in Orlando when the first Helene hit, and then a few weeks later, of course, Milton comes, and, you know, really just devastating. And I think the urgency is picking up. But I think I felt like, I don't know what you're feeling, I felt like at this week there was a lot of hope. There was a lot of, I think, people not just you know, seeing the challenge, but also seeing the opportunity. And it felt like there was a lot of buzz, particularly around this partnership. I know a lot of people came up to me, and I'm just curious, you know, you are, of course, working the event as well, talked to probably many customers, and hopefully you're hearing the same.
Yeah, I think that I would absolutely agree with you. The amount of excitement is unlike anything we've seen. You know, we've been operating, we've done predictive maintenance, industrial use cases for a while now, right? That companies have been trying to achieve those outcomes. But the excitement of making it easier, simpler to get to value is just immense. And, you know, what I feel the biggest outcome we will drive, apart from accelerating AI outcomes, is this push towards how do we make the industry more collaborative. And this is a point that both Mate and JP and JPT and Jean-Paul Tricor and Casper talked about, is that the industry not only needs technology, but also needs radical collaboration. And the technology that's powering that radical collaboration is delta sharing, right? The ability to share data, but with governance in a way that you can trust it, in a way that you can control it without completely losing access to it. So I think those are really powerful ideas, and now we're making them into execution with a certain set of customers. And I think going forward, as the year starts, we're very excited of making all of this available generally to customers.
Yeah, you definitely heard that loud and clear as well, the power of ecosystems here, and just the acknowledgement that there's no way that any one organization can pull this off by themselves, that we really have to work together. And sometimes that's difficult. It's not always easy to build partnerships. There's always, you know, some level of overlap at times, but it is what's required in order for us to meet our shared goals. The other thing that was interesting, well, I remember talking actually in the executive forum about this with a number of customers, and actually Mate was at my table for that conversation. And we also talked about one of the nice things that we are where we are today is that people can innovate faster. They can try quicker. They in the old days, you know, it was almost like we would try to avoid doing proof of concepts. You know, we as a software vendor would avoid them, and of course sometimes customers would too, just because they took so long and it was just really, you know, difficult to implement. But nowadays with the cloud and with the, you know, the availability of information, with the infrastructure that's built to make that data set reusable in this platform, we can actually go innovate faster, and we can go try things out, fail quick. Hopefully learn, and then move from there. And again, I think that was another thing that I think we have to start helping this industry see, is that we have to show them wins along the way. Yeah. It's not about just one big platform that's gonna go solve some one major problem. Yeah. It's about empowering people to use their innovation to identify problems, try to solve them quickly, and then of course iterate and reiterate on those until they can actually drive value.
Yeah, absolutely. I agree with you on that. I'll just add, you know, from my perspective, one of the things that I heard from a lot of organizations is there's so much buzz around AI, and even now with generative AI, even more buzz. You know, but at the same time, you know, it's kind of like equal parts. They're amazed by what the technology can do, and but they are scared about what it can't do or what risks it poses.
Right.
And so you kind of, you know, can end up in this position of almost paralysis and action analysis paralysis, right? Yeah. But what we are trying to do is that we all believe in the promise, and I think, you know, the question that everybody is asking is, where do we get started? You know, how do we make this easier? And I think that's this partnership of AVEVA Connect, bringing high quality industrial data, Databricks, you know, allowing companies to combine it with their enterprise data, allow the best of the open source models to be run on them in a way that companies can actually implement this into their operations is a muscle that almost every organization now needs to build.
Yeah.
And it's not a technology problem by itself, but technology is very, very important. The foundations are very important, but it's also a big change management journey. And I think the industry will need the expertise, all the expertise that they can get. But this is a muscle that an entire industry has to build. And I think, you know, that's something that we all are equal parts excited, but also have a great responsibility to make sure that it is done right.
Yeah, I think the other thing that one of the constraints that we always have in industry is that, you know, just like a brownfield, you know, oftentimes there is digital infrastructure that are put in place inside of industrial organizations that you can't just rip out. I mean, mm-hmm. it's not just about ripping out everything. It's about how do you extend that? Mm. How do you ensure that those continue to operate in the way that they operate, but as well augment it with next generation technology to allow you the innovation. And that's kind of where our belief is at and why we're investing so much in really extending the data set that sits across the design, operate, optimize lifecycle, and making that data set available in a platform and put the data in the platform for things that the platform's good at. And platforms are good at for basically running machine learning. AI is basically perfectly fit for the platform, while simultaneously ensuring that operations continues to run in a secure, reliable manner, mm-hmm. right? Because nobody wants to take down their plant.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely, and I think there's tremendous value and domain expertise that these OT users and OT engineers have. And I think what we are finding with our customers is those data sets are extremely valuable, can be made even more, those analytics, those models can be made even more powerful if we bring more diverse data sets. And this is the point that I think most companies that use Databricks as of today, and we're very early in our life cycle as a company, they are the most innovative companies. The most innovative companies in the world use Databricks, and they have found ways to innovate despite all the challenges, right? And I think the reason why they're doing that is because they are developing this muscle, organizational muscle, to be able to take the best of what's out there in horizontal technologies, in open source models, in open source innovations around data and AI, and make it work for their specific operations, their specific industry. Because each industry is different. They have their unique jargons, they have their unique org structures, they have their unique regulations. And to expect a one big monolithical model to solve for all that is just a little bit naive, right? So I think this is where the mix of domain expertise, giving people the right tools to be able to solve the problems themselves with us assisting them, it does come down to that, and it is coming down to people and making sure they have a process to create value, and then the right platform and foundations
to do that
is absolutely critical.
Yeah. So I think the last thing I'll just get on here is maybe some advice for our joint customers and how they should go about it. I'll start with maybe a point of view that I actually, we were talking again back at some of our tables and some of the hallway conversations, which is, really ensuring that, number one, it's built on a, go solve a specific problem, like understand what the actual problem is, number one. Number two, make sure that, it's not just a data science team trying to solve a problem. Make sure that the people that are responsible for that problem are in that discussion early, right? I mean, I think this is a lesson that you guys have learned as well along your journey.
Yeah. My favorite saying to Databricks technologists, and technologists at our customers' end is, you can have the most elegant data platform in the world, but create no value, right? So I think to what you just talked about is, how do you identify the right problems, the big problems that the organizations are facing, like energy efficiency, like decarbonization of products, like quality, like operations, like logistics, like maintenance. Those big ticket problems that are not being solved by point solutions, and that's where the power of the platform comes in, and we position it at that. But without a clear adoption plan, you're not going to get the real business value, because that's where it's realized. So I think yes, we can have the most elegant platform, but that value can gap is something that we are helping them close. But I think we have to help our customers through the journey of change management to get there.
Awesome. Well, I think obviously we're excited about this partnership. Our customers are super excited. I know that our partners, our joint partners are, because it's not just about AVEVA and Databricks, right? We have a much bigger ecosystem of ISVs, of SIs that actually interoperate with the same ecosystem. So radical collaboration is not about two companies, obviously. It's about how do we, help ignite that collaboration across our wider ecosystem. So I'm personally, as the person that's responsible for partners inside of AVEVA, obviously I'm super excited about what what the future holds for us.
Yeah.
But any last kind of final comments from you?
Yeah, just to you know, give you my perspective, this ecosystem is super important, right? Like, you know, we think that just because two technologies come together, I think that's great, but the principles on which these two technologies are coming together are equally important, right? So it's the same, basically having the same set of standards for data management, having a similar, one singular governance framework that covers data and AI, and that's making radical collaboration possible, right? Without that, it would not have happened. So yes, I had a tremendous excitement. I saw it from our partner community, both ISVs and SIs, really coming in and saying, hey, now we can actually build scalable solutions with this foundation in place. Before, we had to, everything was fragmented, and there was no way we could have actually done something governable and scalable at the same time. So I think tremendous excitement from the SI community, from the ISV community, the technology partners, and I think that's just the start of things to come, because I think this is the right principles and foundations for the industry to truly take the advantage of the innovations that are happening in the tech space.
Awesome. Well, again, thanks so much for your partnership. Thanks for your belief in AVEVA. Well, of course, we believe in the partnership as well, and look forward to trying to drive some impact together.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you, Brian.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.